Chapter 13 is a legal proceeding designed to help you reorganize your debt. It may be instructive to review the previous videos as they build a foundation for understanding the dynamics of Chapter 13. The filing of a Chapter 13 bankruptcy provides the same type of legal protection from creditors as a Chapter 7, as discussed in a previous video. However, the major difference, as a general rule, between the two chapters for the ordinary consumer is that in a Chapter 7, no monies are distributed to creditors. There are exceptions, like the personal injury lawsuit, which is the classic one. In a Chapter 13, there is a plan that provides for some payment to your creditors. Unlike a Chapter 7, where most people are able to totally wipe out their debts, of course, except for those debts as previously discussed in an earlier video, a Chapter 13 filing results in the appointment of a trustee who is responsible for the proper disbursements of money sent to him for the benefit of all of your secured creditors, general unsecured creditors, and unsecured priority creditors. In a separate video, there will be a discussion of the differences between how these debts may be treated in a Chapter 13 as opposed to a Chapter 7. One of the beauties of a Chapter 13 is that it allows you to consolidate your debts into a single payment going forward. A Chapter 13 is restricted to individuals, and thus not corporations, with general unsecured debts, like credit card debts and the like, that are less than $360,475, and secure debt, like mortgage debt and the like, of less than $1,081,400. These figures are adjusted for cost of living changes every 3 years and will adjust again on April 1, 2013, and so forth. Generally, you file a Chapter 13 because your income does not qualify you for a Chapter 7. You have high income. Or if you have significant equity and assets that are not exempt or protected in a Chapter 7 bankruptcy, or your house, co-op, condo, mortgage, or maintenance payments are in delinquency, whether in foreclosure or not, and you wish to save the real property by utilizing one or more of the many Chapter 13 tools that are available to assist you. The means test, as previously discussed in another video, will provide the basis in most instances if you are a 3-year or a 5-year plan. If you are over the median family income as determined by government statistics, which takes into consideration your family income, household size, and location of residence, then you generally will be required to do a 5-year plan. If you are 100% plan, meaning that you are paying off your creditors in full, potentially with no interest to many of your creditors, then a shorter plan is possible, 3 years or even less. Thus, a Chapter 13 plan takes into consideration your family income, do you pass the means test or not, your assets, do you have significant non-exempt assets that would be in jeopardy in a Chapter 7, and the type of creditors that are pursuing you, secured, unsecured, or priority. Does it sound complicated and nuanced? You bet it is. This is just the beginning. Stay tuned.